Welcome to PWX Wrestling here at the Tremont Music Hall. I'm your host, Bruce Snyder, along with Chris Shore. And Chris, it's going to be a wild night of action, starting with our champion, Caleb Konley, who is sort of like a man without a country, doesn't have a championship.
Yeah, Caleb Konley missing that PWX title because Corey Hollis has run off with it. Corey has been a thorn in the side of Caleb Konley for quite some time now. Caleb can't wait to get his hands on this young man.
We'll see if tonight is the night when Caleb is actually able to get the title back.
Yes, we will. And besides that, we've got a great tag team title match tonight. Worst case scenario, their first title defense. And, buddy, they come out of the gates tough tonight. The Bravado Brothers back in PWX looking to get a chance at those titles.
And the Bravado Brothers trying to make an impression right off the bat. Of course, worst case, managed by the Tommy Thomas. So that might be the X factor going in.
The Tommy Thomas is the X factor for that group. They have had great success since teaming up with him. It's led them to that PWX tag team championships.
But we're starting off with quite an exciting match. Everyone's favorite Adam Page coming back to PWX Wrestling against Kyle Matthews, who is double tough. We're going to talk about Kyle Matthews during the match, but what do you think people like most about Adam Page?
I think Adam Page just connects with people because he's just a very down-home kind of kid out of Aarons Creek, Virginia, a young man who worked hard, got to where he is today, and I think that just resonates with our fans.
We very much appreciate you joining us here. Sit back, strap in for a wild night of PWX action. Right now, let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, making his way to the ring, he weighs in at 180 pounds, wrestling out of Atlanta, Georgia, Kyle Matthews!
First time seeing Kyle Matthews here in PWX, Bruce.
But the reputation of this man, he is double tough. He is not afraid to mix it up. And Adam Page, I'm sure, has done his scouting report and knows this, but he better be careful.
Kyle Matthews has a tough road tonight. Facing Adam Page any other night is tough enough, but Adam Page returning from injury here. Listen to this crowd.
Approaching the ring, he weighs in at 207 pounds. Wrestling out of Aarons Creek, Virginia, Adam Page!
Corn-fed, born and raised in Aarons Creek, Virginia, Adam Page. This kid has got a big future in front of him.
And especially a favorite of a lot of our lady fans tonight.
But
I'll tell you what,
he's
handsome, but it's also about how you wrestle. And this man can get the job done.
Adam Page coming back. He's had some tough times here in PWX, getting his nose broke live right here at the Tremont Music Hall by Cedric Alexander. Kicked him over the top rope with that concussion on delivery. And Kyle Matthews says, hey, let's do this straight up. Good for him. Welcome to PWX, kid.
Kyle Matthews trying to make an impression. I think he has. And once again, they shake hands. So they shake both hands.
We have a sportsmanship-type crowd here at the Tremont Music Hall.
And now our referee getting in on the action also. You know what, Chris? I might as well shake your hand off.
Yeah, let's do
it's
this.
A pleasure.
All right, yeah.
Okay, nobody, now we're all covered.
Nobody cheered for us. All right. So we're not even Ring of Honor yet. We're out here shaking hands. What is that all about?
PWX Championship Wrestling. I'm Bruce Snyder along with Chris Shore. And right now we're watching Adam Page in the brownish gray trunks against Kyle Matthews in the blue. Page taking him over, and Matthews countering him, has him between his legs. Page able to work out, now on top of the opponent.
Now the thing we have to watch out for, I mentioned that nose being broken, but Adam Page has been out very recently with a broken hand. That has kept him on the shelf for the past 8 weeks, and we need to see if Kyle Matthews goes after that injured hand. Adam Page assures me he's 100%. But you know how these guys are. They will say anything to get back in that ring.
Absolutely. The guys want to come back.
Oh, look at the bridge. Look at this.
Let's see if we can get an early submission here.
The Muda lock. You hear the fans chanting for Muda.
And Chris, talk about the strength that bridge requires.
Oh, it's unbelievable.
The neck muscles and the shoulders.
I watch these guys go backstage before every show. They sit back there. They do these neck bridges. They do hundreds of them. They roll them around. They can Chase Brown can one of the standards here in PWX. He can hold that move for probably 3-4 minutes. I mean, it's unbelievable the strength and the tenacity it takes to build that level of flexibility and power in these guys.
And it also talks about the level of condition that our PWX wrestlers are in.
That's right.
All right.
And the dedication it takes to get there. I mean, this is why we are the best independent promotion in the Southeast.
And, in fact, that's one of the reasons why I'm so excited to be a part of this. I asked around. I heard about PWX, and I heard about the great competition, and we're seeing it right now. And right now, Adam Page has Kyle Matthews in a predicament, but Matthews able to counter.
Well, some good mat wrestling there from Kyle Matthews.
And so far, very clean and some very good chain wrestling.
Let's see. Stats has got something here for me on Kyle. Always good to have Stats around. Too hot for TV, Kyle Matthews. I don't know if he's that hot. Is he too hot for TV, Bruce?
Why he's sizzling?
Might be the lights, too. Hey, jumping over here. Good hip toss. Paige right there. Look at this. Look at the agility of both of these men.
Now, an arm takedown, and basically they're countering each other with a double drop. And it's almost like looking at a mirror.
Welcome to Kyle Matthews, Adam, or welcome to PWX, Kyle Matthews, says Adam Page.
And Matthews again saying, good job. And Page saying, thank you, good job to you. Let's go back to wrestling.
Matthews trying to get this crowd worked up here. I think they just go back to doing what they're doing. This crowd will be right there with them.
You know, it looks like the crowd originally was with Adam Page, but Matthews slowly making a good impression with the crowd. They lock up again.
This match has been very even from the beginning. Neither one of these guys able to sustain any sort of leverage for longer. But now Adam Page has a good head scissor there. Matthews trying to find his way out.
Matthews,
look at this.
Up on his neck, up on his head. Trying to escape, and he's able to escape. Very nice, and turn it into a predicament for Page.
Page was right there at the ropes, immediately saw it. Adam Page, former Innovative Television champion. Losing that to Chip Day. Adam Page looking to climb his way up the card here. Just recently signed a contract with Ring of Honor. We'll be seeing more of Adam Page, and I think anytime you can see more of Adam Page, Bruce, it's a win for us fans.
I notice a lot of the wrestlers here also working with Ring of Honor. Again, the talent here, incredible. Page now.
And there's Stats. I knew he'd come through with me. Oh, great dropkick there from Kyle Matthews. I'm finding out now I've been wrestling 11 years, started at the ripe old age of 15 as well. And now we're seeing a little aggressiveness out of Kyle Matthews, still the young Kyle Matthews, 26 years
and
old.
And this might be part of Matthews' game plan. Start with the chain wrestling and then take it a little more aggressive if need be.
You ever been chopped like that, Bruce?
Thankfully, no.
I have one time.
How's it feel?
There's the hand. I talked about it. Adam Page hurt that hand, and he chopped Kyle Matthews. It might have been all the break Matthews needed. To answer your question about chops, though, I don't know if I can accurately describe it on television. It sucks.
Snap suplex again, and Matthews, again with the two count, and goes right back into putting Page in a predicament.
But we are probably, 15 feet from Adam Page right now, and you can see his chest glowing from that chop from here.
And that's part of what this human chess game is all about. Dealing with the pain, and a lot of people when they watch this, they forget that you're trying to outthink your opponent while dealing with all the pain that's throbbing through you. And a lot of people don't realize that it's a factor. You almost just have to ignore the pain, like right there with the double boot to the face and then a rollover.
Quick roll up, he's got him stacked on his shoulders. Page able to escape. Yeah, no, they've done studies. They say that being in a wrestling match is like being in a car wreck. These guys do it night after night after night. They put their bodies through that level of abuse.
All trying to climb the ladder. Right. All trying to get to the top.
All going for that gold. Which, of course, right now held by Caleb Conley or held by Corey Hollis, depending on how you want to look at it.
You know, I'm watching Paige closely to see if he favors his injured parts. And so far, I mean, except for the one situation with the hand, he seems to be doing okay. But as this match gets deeper, will he be able to still fight at peak efficiency? Kyle Matthews flipping him over once again. And that hurts. You're talking about no give. But yeah. Somehow Paige able to kick out of it. But you know he's got to be smarting from that. And you wonder if Matthews' game plan is just a wear down Paige.
I mean, yeah, drop kick to the back of the neck. Adam Paige suffering a concussion the night that he broke his nose. And of course, he might have broke somebody else's nose. Might have broke Kyle Matthews' nose right there. Matthews is wobbly a little bit.
Oh. Matthews with a kick, and you got to wonder where that landed.
Super kick right in the chest, throat area, it looked like. Paige took that one hard.
And now he's got him in a sleeper hold. And he's got him in the ring, but he doesn't have it cinched up correctly. And Paige able to get out of it. And Paige trying to go for the sleeper, but it's countered now.
Saito suplex there from Kyle Matthews. Is it enough? Just two.
And again, Chris, it's very interesting how these two almost mirror images of each other, not necessarily in the way they look, but in the way they think out there in the ring, in the techniques that they use. I mean, this has been, as you said, a very even match.
You know, Adam Paige, coming back from that injury, I was worried there might be a little bit of ring rust on him. That doesn't seem to be the case, but you can tell Kyle Matthews has been wrestling as of late. He looks very crisp in that ring. He's hanging with Adam Paige. This has been a great match, Bruce.
Kyle Matthews making quite an introduction to the PWX fans and the PWX viewers. And Paige counters. And it looks like Matthews is rocked.
Now here's an interesting.
Or Matthews might have been playing possum because he looked rocked, and then he came back with that uppercut forearm.
Oh, Paige down low. What's he got planned here? A running knee. Was that a tooth?
Not anymore.
Oh. Oh. What a tough back elbow that was. Power slam by Paige as he got him here. No.
Oh. And it could have been just that quick. I mean, this has been back and forth, completely even. And Paige almost caught Matthews. One step ahead of him, Matthews able to fight out at the last minute. Paige now. Matthews countering. Paige countering Matthews. Off the ropes.
Look out, spin him around here. He's got that arm. Can he get him? Oh, it's a Black Widow.
Trying to cinch in. Does he have it cinched?
He's got him hooked in the Black Widow. We've seen championships won with this.
Chris, I was going to say, didn't look like he had it completely cinched in.
I think that front leg was a little bit loose. You didn't have a quite standing shooting star press. Quick cover here for Paige, no.
2 9/10. It's that close. Both these guys have come so close to wins. Paige now. As the match continues, no rest in pro wrestling. Paige expending his energy on the turnbuckle, climbing to the top. Watch out for the roof.
Matthews had it scouted. Oh, dropkick there. Now look out here. Started to say, spins him around for a tornado DDT. He spiked him. Is that going to be enough? I believe it might be. Oh, God. Kyle Matthews. Now, what I was getting ready to say, Bruce, is he's got his Adam Paige has got to be careful here. The slurpee kick, that's what Kyle uses to put away his opponents, is a kick in the corner very similar to the concussion on delivery that Cedric Alexander used to break Adam Paige's face. Adam Paige is in real danger here if that gets set up for him again, because he has already felt the wrath of a very similar kick from Cedric Alexander.
And Matthews now. Trying to keep the momentum going. Once again countered, and then Matthews countering that with an elbow.
Oh,
and Paige. Page with a drop kick.
Look at the height of Page to get Matthews up there on that second rope.
And it looked like he stunned Matthews with that drop kick because there's no give. There's no place for Matthews to go. He absorbed that impact completely.
And now what's Page got here? Whoa! What a neck breaker off the second rope, a cover, two, and how is that not it?
And can you give it up to Kyle Matthews for somehow kicking out on that? I thought the match was over. I don't know how Kyle Matthews was able to recover from that. And Adam Page maybe looking a little frustrated, maybe thinking the same thing. How could he not already be the winner? Matthews trying to get his wits. Page.
See, Page had to be careful there, and he was protected, but he wasn't protected from that kick.
Matthews now to the midsection again, and Matthews up and over, roll up. Oh! Goodness.
Super kick right in the face, and look out, this could be it. This could be that slurpy kick. It is! Adam Page got his nose broke with that. What's going to happen here? Three, oh my God!
And you called it. Kyle Matthews. Able to win a
Your
great
winner of the bout, Kyle Matthews.
In a great match, great chain wrestling. Both guys giving no quarter, asking no quarter, and look at the fans standing up, giving them a standing ovation. And I think you can see why. Adam Page still down. You got to wonder if his nose is okay or if it's been re-injured. And you were talking about that. Yep. You were concerned about that.
Might have been a weakness there that Kyle Matthews saw. He hits him with that slurpy kick, and it's enough to put him away. But Kyle Matthews showing his respect for Adam Page. An unbelievable match, and Kyle Matthews victorious.
And Kyle Matthews and Adam Page shaking hands. A great display of sportsmanship. And easily, I think, the fans truly enjoying this match, and for good reason. But Kyle Matthews able to come out with the win over Adam Page.
Adam Page coming back from injury. Again, you have to think ring rust might have had something to do with it.
For the next match. For the next match. Just when it finish up, that's when we take it hard.
What's Corey Hollis doing out here?
I'm not sure.
Adam Page, everybody. Adam Page.
Corey was
the welcome mat to PWX.
Oh, that's unnecessary.
Adam, you should know, buddy. Nice guys, they all finish last. And you're being a nice guy. Adam, I don't have a problem with you at all. Truth, believe it? I see a lot of myself in you.
I don't really see any of that, Corey.
Yeah. We're both good country boys, right? Yeah. You even have the Alabama logo on your back. Yeah. 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 Adam, in the past few months, I've been making a name for myself because I don't wait for somebody to give it to me. I've been taking it. It's not about getting friends in this business is about the money.
Corey Hollis.
You need to think about it, buddy.
It's also about respect.
Not to Corey Hollis. He's mentioned all the things that he's done. He slapped a woman around, Bruce. He's cost people matches. He's stolen the PWX Heavyweight Championship belt. But
well, Corey,
what's going to happen? He's going to get his title shot at Caleb Conley.
Top Rope Belts is the world leader in custom design title belts, specializing in creating a unique belt for each and every client. Our mission is to focus on innovation, creativity, and the highest standards of quality. Clients from all around the world, ranging from wrestling, MMA, corporations, and professional sports teams. Are you looking for a championship belt to represent you or your company? Look no further than Top Rope Belts. Pro Belts can be contacted at area code 336-470-3071 or at toprobelts.com.
Winston Salem, Saturday, November 30th. WrestleCade is back. The 2013 lineup. Hold on your head. It just might explode. Diamond Dallas Page, Carlito, The Rock and Roll Express,
WrestleCade,
Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Meet him firsthand at the WrestleCade Fan Fest. Stars like Tony Atlas, Steve Corino, Tully Blanchard, Robbie E., Shelly Martinez, Nikita Koloff, Gunner. Think we're done? Not even close. Matt Hardy, The Headbanger, The Raging Bull Manny Fernandez, Hurricane Helms, Ryan Shamrock, Baby Doll, Rick Steiner,
WrestleCade,
Jake the Snake Roberts. Check out the complete lineup at WrestleCade.com. And follow them on Facebook and Twitter. Looking for tickets? Just 10 bucks and up. Do not wait. This show will sell out.
WrestleCade!
Saturday, November 30th, WrestleCade 2013. Be there.
Hey, I'm Chad, owner of American Air Heating Cooling, with the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Have I got a deal for you?
Tell him Rick sent you and get $400 off a new Maytag heating and cooling system.
Woo! Whoa, just because you have an office here doesn't mean you own the place.
What the Nature Boy says goes.
Woo! That's $400 off a new Maytag heating and cooling system.
Well, what are you waiting for? Call American Air Heating and Cooling today. Woo! Woo, 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 woo!
PWX Live Event is coming to a town near you. November 22nd at the Hickory Metro Convention Center. Also on November 23rd at Cabarrus Arena and Event Center. See PWX star Caleb Conley, Cedric Alexander, and the newly formed Country Jack. Once again, join us for two huge nights of pro wrestling. Tickets start at $15. For more information, please visit PWXProWrestling.com.
Why, Skyler, why? Why did you do what you did to Jake Manning? Why did you turn your back on your tag team partner? Well, let me get one thing straight, Jake Manning. You were never my tag team partner. Pro wrestling isn't a team sport. It's a sport of individuals. Trample the weak, hurdle the dead. And that's exactly what I'm going to do tonight, Jake Manning, because you're going to be my stepping stone on the way to the PWX Championship. Because Jake Manning, look around you. You want to be an honorable man? This is a business full of crooks, thieves, liars, and 9 times out of 10, greed will always trump over honor. Tonight, Jake Manning, honor gets thrown out the window, because in this business of smoke and mirrors, you're looking at the one thing that is real. The Southern Savior is real. John Skyler is real. I am real.
Well, that music can only mean one thing.
I think
the
we know
artist
who it is.
Formerly known as the Chiva Kid, Mr.
And
Andrew Everett.
Approaching the ring, he weighs in at 180 pounds. From Burlington, North Carolina, Andrew Everett.
Soon-to-be master of the Tongan Death Grip, Andrew Everett. He's still learning the move, Bruce. He hasn't quite got it down yet.
That's true. However, he's having a good time while learning. Now, here's the thing. Oh, high flying. Now, here's the thing which I'm a little confused about. He used to wrestle with a mask on.
Correct.
Why would he take it off if he was doing so well with it on?
He had been underneath the mask since he was 15 years old. He decided that it was time that he showed everyone the face of the man. As we're underway here, oh, and a fast start there from Andrew Everett. He decided he wanted to let everybody see the face underneath that mask. And here you see the tease of the Tongan Death Grip.
And this is going to be your classic style. This is going to be the man who likes to stay on the mat versus the high flyer. And that has long been really the big debate in wrestling. Who's more of a wrestler, the high flyer or the mat wrestler? Maybe we'll find out tonight.
Well, Chase Brown from the Grand Carnival Fair says he can stretch any man and will ride any man to hell. Andrew Everett, he specifically called out, as he put it, flippity-do, guys. Andrew Everett falls underneath that category, but don't get it twisted, Bruce. Andrew Everett is a great tactician. Again, been wrestling since the ripe old age of 15.
Absolutely. And you can tell Everett having a good time, smile on his face, taking the match seriously, but also confident in his abilities.
Chase Brown, coming back from an injury, he's talked about separating his shoulder. He did separate his shoulder.
He's also talking about his ear.
Yeah, his ear. He's been out for several months with that shoulder injury, and now he's back. He's lost his mustache, but he's found some new aggressiveness. And I talked about this before he injured that shoulder, that what Chase needed maybe just one more thing to put him over the top. He's got great skills in the ring, and there he's trying to ride him. He's about, Everett quickly to the ropes.
Everett able to get into the ropes.
You hear "ride that goat" as the fans referring to Everett's days as the Chiva Kid.
Or some people actually called him Goat Mask.
Well, that's what it was. It was a goat mask.
All right, they're tying up once again.
Chase, you're not going to see. We talked about the high flying. Andrew Everett, if he feels necessary, he will go to the top. It sounds like he's decided to put that aside for now and wrestle Chase Brown. I don't know if that's the smartest thing to do. I mean, Everett's got great skill, but Chase Brown is a catch wrestler. That's what he is.
That is true.
And
but
as just real quick, Bruce, as great a tactician as Everett is, he excels coming off that top rope.
Everett working on that arm right now. Oh, and a forearm by Brown. And
that's
he's got Everett wrong just a little bit. And he was a step ahead of Everett there.
Oh, my God.
Two steps ahead.
Inside out with that clothesline. Everett grabbing the neck. He's had some injury problems as of late. He's been favoring that neck as of late.
And you have to give Brown credit for staying a step or two ahead of Everett right there.
Yeah, he had to outthink him there. You're not going to outquick Andrew Everett. So Chase Brown, aware of where he was in the ring, realized what he thought Everett was going to do, rolled the dice, was right on that, and now he's got Everett in the side headlock, but starting to find some energy.
Brown grabbing a bunch of hair and the referee apparently letting it happen. He got a two count. I guess it's only illegal if the ref catches you.
Well, Chase Brown's not afraid to use every edge of the rules. Like I said, this is a very surprising change for Chase Brown. He was, before, he would play fast and loose with the rules, but this is more aggressive than I have ever seen Chase Brown.
Everett trying to battle back with a shot right to the kisser. But Brown countering that with a forearm. And then a kick to the midsection. And right now you'd have to say Brown, not only the aggressor, but if they were scoring on points, I'd think you'd have to agree that Brown would be the leader. Of course, we're not scoring on points, but right now Brown has all the momentum. Everett's going to have to do something to counter that.
Yeah, the good news is if this was UFC, you would have to believe Chase Brown would be your winner right now. But here's the bad news for Chase Brown. This isn't UFC. Andrew Everett still has plenty of fight left in him after that two count there.
And Everett able to kick out again, but once again a two count. And this match may be taking its toll on Everett.
I think you go back to that clothesline at the very beginning of the match there, Bruce. I mean, that knocked Everett out of his game, hurt his neck, and there you see the amazing effort. And now the target death grip! The target death grip, he's got him. Chase just looks uncomfortable. And now Chase.
It's also giving
Everett. This is what I was talking about. Everett still learning this hold, and he paid for it there.
He did, and Chase now trying to take advantage, and a sou play right on his back.
You're not me.
And you know, Chase Brown maybe a little overconfident there. If he had cinched up Everett maybe a little tighter, he would have had the three count. Instead, the match continues.
Chase Brown lucky that Andrew Everett's still trying to learn the Tongan death grip because he had it locked in for a second. But the effectiveness of that hold still eludes the young Andrew Everett. What doesn't elude him? Oh.
And once again, Chase Brown a step or two ahead of Everett.
And it's not that often that you see that happen. No. Like I said, you're not going to outquick Andrew Everett.
But
like
Everett,
you see there.
Everett, a beautiful maneuver to land back on his feet. And now Brown counters that.
Oh!
And comes down hard, Everett does.
Belly to back throw, got him all the way over.
That
Andrew
could
Everett
be
might
it.
Be in trouble.
One.
It's a big upset.
But Everett able to kick out. But Everett right now is probably seeing a few stars.
Wow, Chase Brown with an explosive belly-to-back throw that almost put Everett away. Chase Brown has had a little bit of success here recently, but not a lot. But, boy, a win over Andrew Everett would immediately catapult him to the top of everyone's talking about list.
And Brown once again with those forearms. But Everett able to counter. And now the two starting to go back and forth and mix it up.
Uh-oh.
Everett off the ropes.
Right in the mouth. I've never seen this aggressiveness from Chase Brown. Look out. Everett a little bit faster there. Oh, look out. If he gets going here. This is what we see. That spinning, that flying heel kick.
And Everett trying to get the fans rallied up.
Yeah, he's starting to feel it here. Dives in for that Superman punch.
And again, off the ropes. Uh-oh. And he catches Brown once again. And all of a sudden, the match is turned. But Brown able to kick out.
Springboard kick.
Hey, you know, Chris, credit to both these wrestlers who have taken the best shot of their opponent.
Yeah.
And they're still around. And that's what makes PWX wrestling so good. And why fans are so excited about this promotion.
Everett got planned here. Now it's a low ceiling here in the Tremont Music Hall. But that doesn't mean he won't fly. Look out! Oh, went for a twisting plancha, but took too long, probably looking at that low ceiling, and Chase Brown able to get out of the way.
And you know, let's talk about that ceiling. How do you think that impacts, especially the high flyers, their strategy, knowing that if they go too high, they could get tangled up in those beams up there?
Well, every time we've seen Everett before we came here, he would do that shooting star press off the second rope. Oh! DVD, Death Valley Driver, that might be it there. Oh, no, we got it. Wow, and I cannot believe that. And Chase Brown now with a submission hold.
This is what Brown was talking about. And Everett hanging on.
He's got him right in the middle of the ring, Andrew Everett. It might have a Kimura. I can't see. It's on the other side of where we're sitting.
But Everett able to reverse it and flip it over.
Oh, but Chase still has that hold. It is a Kimura lock. We've seen people break arms from this. Everett trying to find a way around. Oh,
Everett able to counter him, rolls him down.
He's got him rolled
up. And gets a two count. Great match from these two.
Oh, Pele kick there.
It looked like he got him just with the tip of his foot, just enough.
It drives him down. Falcon arrow. No. Yeah, I think Chase Brown anticipated that kick, sat down to try to get out of the way of it, and it worked. Popped up, but Everett aware he hadn't made contact and immediately grabbed for that Falcon arrow.
And that's about the seventh near fall in this match as both of these guys go back and forth. And now Brown getting shoved into the corner by Everett.
A rough looking standing head scissor there. Everett, his legs might be giving out. He's absorbed a lot of punishment here. Can we see that springboard shooting star press?
He's gonna try again.
Yes!
And I think that's it.
Unbelievable!
What a match. Andrew Everett able to get the three count on Chase Brown.
Everett!
Top Rope Belts is the world leader in custom design title belts. Specializing in creating a unique belt for each and every client, our mission is to focus on innovation, creativity, and the highest standards of quality. Clients from all around the world, ranging from wrestling, MMA, corporations, and professional sports teams. Are you looking for a championship belt to represent you or your company? Look no further than Top Rope Belts. Rope Belts can be contacted at area code 336-470-3071 or at toprobebelts.com.
Winston Salem, Saturday, November 30th, WrestleCade is back. The 2013 lineup, hold on your head, it just might explode. Diamond Dallas Page, Carlito, The Rock and Roll Express,
WrestleCade,
Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Meet him firsthand at the WrestleCade Fan Fest. Stars like Tony Atlas, Steve Corino, Tully Blanchard, Robbie Eaton, Shelly Martinez, Nikita Koloff, Gunner,
think we're done? Not even close. Matt Hardy, the Headbanger. The Raging Bull Manny Fernandez. Hurricane Helms. Ryan Shamrock. Baby Doll. Rick Steiner.
WrestleCade.
Jake the Snake Roberts. Check out the complete lineup at WrestleCade.com. And follow them on Facebook and Twitter. Looking for tickets? Just 10 bucks and up. Do not wait. This show will sell out.
WrestleCade.
Saturday, November 30th, WrestleCade 2013. Be there.
PWX Live Event is coming to a town near you. November 22nd at the Hickory Metro Convention Center. Also on November 23rd at Cabarrus Arena and Event Center. See PWX star Caleb Conley, Cedric Alexander, and the newly formed Country Jack. Once again, join us for two huge nights of pro wrestling. Tickets start at $15. For more information, please visit PWXProWrestling.com.
Tag team action as we get ready for our PWX tag team title match. The worst case scenario has their hands full tonight in their first major title defense as they face Grandma Bravado's favorite team, the Bravado Brothers. Lancelot and Harlem Bravado. Wow, Harlem looks like a wizard or something.
Lancelot shaking hands, high-fiving the fans. Harlem on the other side.
So it is Harlem with the beard, Lancelot without.
And there they go. And I think it's obvious that the crowd is going to be behind Bravado tonight. And really, Bravado, from what I understand, they say cheer us if you want, boo us if you want. It doesn't matter as long as Grandma likes us.
That's right. That's right. This team has burst on the scene as of late, capturing those PWX tag team titles in a hard-fought match. And you're guaranteed, I bet tonight, Bruce, to see the move of the night if your tag team champion is the worst-case scenario.
And there's the Tommy Thomas.
Let's not talk about the Tommy Thomas. Oh,
leading him out.
We got help tonight. Who is this?
Well, the Tommy Thomas does not want to get the pants dirty. So he's got someone helping him up. Ethan Case and Elijah Evans, the fourth. Because we don't want to confuse him with Elijah Evans Jr. There are your PWX Tag Team Champions. Of course, winning that championship when Jake Manning was double-crossed by his partner, John Skyler.
Let's send it up to Corky Franks for the official introductions. Oh, no, wait, idiot with a microphone, idiot with a microphone.
As with any unconquered empire, my clients, the team of Elijah Evans IV and Ethan Case, AKA the worst case scenario, have been trying to obtain the PWX Tag Team Championships. And I guess like the song says, they started from the bottom and now they're here.
You're not a good rapper, Tommy Thomas.
They will never. And you know what? I'm going to do a throwback. And the Tommy means ever. Yeah. Lose these tag team championships. They will have them until the day they die. And it looks like tonight, these two are going to be the next victims. Thank you, Worst Case Security. Thank you.
Worst Case Security. Okay.
Good luck, Bravados. You're definitely going to need it.
The Tommy Thomas setting the bar high.
I told you, idiot
Ladies
with a microphone.
This bout is set for one fall, and it's for the PWX Tag Team Championships. Introducing first, to my left, the challengers. They weigh in at a combined weight of 445 pounds. From Draper, North Carolina, Lancelot and Harlem, the Bravado Brothers.
Bravado Brothers out of Eden, North Carolina. Grandma Bravado's favorite team and a heck of a challenger.
And their
opponents. Looks like the favorite team of
right,
fans.
They were accompanied to the ring by their managing consultant, the Tommy Thomas.
Boom.
They stand in tonight at 11 feet, 11 inches tall, from the Alaskan interior. Ethan Case and Elijah Evans, the fourth, the worst. Case-scenario!
They stand 11 feet, 11 inches. What, are they going to wrestle on top of each other's shoulders?
Yeah, well, you know, it's they're an interesting crew. They are the, you see their self-streamer party. From the Alaskan wilderness. It's hard to believe these guys did not know each other in Alaska, did not meet each other until they were both in wrestling, found out they were both from Alaska, and now they are your PWX Tag Team Champions. But for how long? What do you think, Bruce? You think the Bravado Brothers might have a chance here tonight against worst case scenario?
It's going to take some good, fast teamwork, and the Bravado Brothers certainly have that going. So can they do it? Absolutely. Will they do it? Remains to be seen. But, you know, the one thing you have to say about worst case, they certainly don't lack for confidence.
No, they do not. No, they do not. And look, I call him an idiot with a microphone because he is. But let's just tell it like it is. Worst case scenario, before the Tommy Thomas, tag team. After the Tommy Thomas, tag team champions. Those are the facts. And as much as I hate to give him any credit for it, you have to believe that the Tommy Thomas was instrumental in putting the belts around these guys' waists.
And you bring up a good point, but it's one thing to get to the top. It's another thing to stay at the top. Can the Tommy Thomas keep the worst-case scenario on top of the tag team mountain? We'll see. Or will Bravado make it the shortest reign in PWX tag team history?
Well, you know, that's the thing is when you're not at the top of the mountain, you're just trying to get to the top. Once you're at the top, everybody comes after you. You are a marked man or a marked team in this case. And the first team with their eyes set, the Bravado Brothers, again, these guys have wrestled all over the world. They've done tours in Japan, tours through the Ring of Honor, and have been teaming together for many, many years. I mean, they're brothers.
This is Harlem in now. Harlem, the taller one of the brothers, against Ethan Case. And Harlem working on the left arm, trying to keep Case from tagging, and able to pull him away.
You may not know this, but Ethan Case's wife is like the nicest person alive. And I'm trying to figure out what she did wrong to be stuck with this guy.
I think she's bought a lot of earplugs. Double tag team action coming down on Ethan Case.
Two down from referee Charles Culler there. Yeah, no, it amazes me that someone that nice would put up with a jerk like Ethan Case. But again, a jerk with a belt. So maybe the gold has something to do with it.
The belt means money.
What are you trying to say? You trying to say the money means girls?
In a lot of cases, yes.
Oh, that's fair.
Of course, don't take my word for it. I'm sure the Tommy Thomas will agree with me on that.
As long as he doesn't come over here.
Well, we're going to try and keep him as far away as possible. Right now, Harlem and Ethan Case in the ring. And, you know, Harlem doesn't have a lot of hair to pull.
Oh, what is Tommy Thomas doing?
And that's ridiculous.
Interjecting himself in the match, pulling the rope down. Lancelot Bravado goes crashing to the floor. And now the security guard getting involved, too. What?
Elijah Evans, the fourth, taking advantage. And I mean, that's just ridiculous. There was no call for that. The Tommy Thomas is not a competitor. He's a manager. He should stay outside And instead, he lays a smack into Harlem. This is ridiculous.
Tommy Thomas, what a jerk this guy is.
You know what? He's picking and choosing his spots, and the referee's letting him get away with it. So until the referee tells him to stop, the Tommy Thomas is probably just going to continue.
I don't think Charles Keller has seen it. I think that's one thing, the worst case scenario. I mean, you know, how many weasels do you see before they're on top of you? That's what these guys are. They're weasels. They're able to weasel into the right positions every single time, and that's why they've been successful.
And they are taking their toll on Harlem. Some fast teamwork by worst case scenario. Elijah Evans a fourth, leaving Harlem wide open, and Ethan Case taking advantage. Harlem trying to fight back. He desperately needs to tag his partner, but instead he gets a knee to the back.
Charles Keller saw that one, but the difference is that at least Elijah Evans is supposed to be in this match. Tommy Thomas should be sitting to the back.
And once again, Harlem able to kick out Case, keeping the pressure on. Case again.
Ethan Case with a lot of mind games there. Yeah. Usually guys get snap-mared over like that. There's usually a kick to the back. Harlem Bravado is kind of mentally preparing himself for it, trying to find himself, realize what positions he's in, expects that kick in the back, and suddenly his head's ripped back, and Ethan Case is cinched in a hold like that. It messes with your mind. You don't know what's coming or going in the ring. Oh! What a big kick there from Harlem Bravado. Look out.
But his partner able to come to his... But Harlem able to use the turnbuckle and turn that into his advantage.
A big tornado DDT and a great timing there from Lancelot.
And he gets the tag.
Bravado, here comes Lancelot.
And Lancelot coming in like a house on fire. Lancelot with the chops. Lancelot. It's reversed, but he's able to use his legs to send Ethan Case into the turnbuckles.
Ethan Case with a mouthful of turnbuckle there. Look out, Lancelot flying in. Wow, what a hard knee. Keep watching.
Oh, boy, Case is quick. I'm sorry, I meant Lancelot is quick. And Case is finding out.
Case is quickly getting...
destroyed.
Yeah, his mouth mashed here.
And one thing that Lancelot is able to do is allow his brother time to recover.
Clubbing forearm there. Clothesline is not enough. 2.5.
And the Tommy Thomas
starting to
looks
sweat
a little
bit.
Worried. Case now with the elbows. And now it's countered, reversed, up, smash.
Wow, drives him down, goes Lancelot. And oh, good thing Elijah Evans was there. We might have had new PWX Tag Team Champions.
Elijah Evans the fourth in for the save. And gets tossed out for his trouble.
Oh, look out here. Lancelot Bravado, is he planning on flying? Look, security in the way.
And Lancelot, security saying no, and providing the distraction, and Lancelot pays the price.
Ethan Case punching him in the kidneys.
You know what? You might not like their tactics, but you have to admire their teamwork.
Well, I mean, it speaks for itself. It's working. I don't know how much I admire it.
The bottom line is trying to get your hand raised. And right now, the worst case scenario is in control.
Elijah Evans just choking Lancelot Bravado. Lancelot got that hot tag. It looked like they were going to be able to put away worst case scenario and maybe win those titles. Just look at, you know, it's just the meanness, the nastiness, the dirtiness. Taking the tape, dragging it across Lancelot's face, not enough to pin him, obviously, but just to aggravate him, to irritate him, to get in his head.
And the other thing is, really, if you count the Tommy Thomas and also the worst case scenario security, that's four guys on one side against two.
It is.
I mean, how fair is that? You're right. They should be sent to the back. But instead, once again, Case, and now Elijah Evans. And I'll tell you what, Lancelot, his neck hard down on the rope and now sent down to the canvas. And it's taken its toll on Lancelot. Evans, shot to the solar plexus. Lancelot trying to fight his way out. And now they're trading. And Lancelot now getting beaten down. And Elijah Evans using those legs. And finally, Harlem can't take it. But the referee says, uh-uh, you're not allowed in here, and sends him back. Why does he do that for one side and not the other?
I think it's just a circumstantial sort of thing.
But it's frustrating from a fan standpoint.
I'm sure it is. Now, worst case scenario, they have great tag team tandem offense here. There you see it. Missed him. Drops him down for the leg drop.
Is that
with
enough?
Cover here.
Somehow Lancelot able to power out.
Elijah Evans, the fourth slow getting from the ring. Might have been all the time that Lancelot needed to kick out of that. But, wow, just a knee to the face.
And really, Lancelot has to tag his brother in. Harlem is rested. Harlem needs to get the tag. But, of course, Ethan Case is not going to allow that. Case going again for the pin in combination. One, two. And Lancelot able to fight his way out.
Yeah, but not every time he kicks out, he expends more energy. That's just one less drop of gas in the tank spent kicking out. And eventually that gas tank goes dry.
Which is why he needs to tag his brother.
That's right. He does. No question about it. Very close there. Worst case scenario, very good at tag team. And now look at him mocking. And again, this is what happens. This is how we end up with these problems.
And meanwhile, the tag made on the other side and the referee allowing that. So Elijah Evans back in, the fresh man in. And once again, you have to admire the tactics of worst case scenario. I mean, they are keeping the fresh man in. Lancelot fighting hard and catches Evans. The power slam.
What an unbelievable slam. Lancelot grabbing the big man out of the air.
Can he tag his partner, though? That's the big question. And Evans will not allow it.
Evans somehow got to his feet quick enough to
get
the tag.
And he finally makes the tag. And here comes Harlem. And Harlem with a shot. And now with another shot on Evans.
Well, Harlem is on fire here.
And Harlem with a kick.
A pump kick that nearly took the head of Elijah Evans off his neck. Tommy Thomas frustrated as he can be.
And Harlem is fired up and trying to get the fans fired up as well. Hard into the turnbuckle and now sending him to the other side. It's reversed. Harlem one step ahead of Evans.
Great diving clothesline there. Is that going to be enough?
Almost. Two count. Take a look at the partners, both sides, Ethan Case, Lancelot.
Oh, you talked about it, Ethan Case recovering, helping his partner, first one to his feet.
And the referee allowing this double team.
I think he's trying to get Case out of there, but he's not listening. Oh, look at Harlem use both guys there. Look out here, exploder into the corner on his partner. Harlem Bravado with that exploder suplex.
And that's why Bravado is so well liked all across the country. Moves like that. And the fans starting to chant Bravado. Harlem up and over.
Security was there, so Harlem went back in the ring. And now security up on the apron again. The referee's got to get rid of him. Oh!
Oh, it's security taking a shot. Harlem saying, I can't take this anymore.
Look out, Harlem flies!
Hard on not only security, but on Ethan Case. And Harlem saying, you want to fight 4-on-2? I can do that. And security might be out. And the Tommy Thomas telling his man to get back up.
He's got to do something here. Harlem Bravado on the top rope. He's a big guy, low ceiling, dives, hits the frog splash. We got new champions.
Oh,
oh my God, Ethan Case kicked out. I can't believe it.
Opportunity lost for the Bravados. You've got.
Sorry, Eli Evans was kicking out.
You've got Ethan Case who was down, but
there's
now
Ethan
they're both
Case.
In. And Case planting his face. A Case face plant into the mat.
Come on.
Harlem feeling the effects of that. And now, once again, a double team. And they've got him.
This
doesn't
move.
Look good.
Oh, drops him down. Is that going to be enough to retain here? Two and no. Oh.
You've got to give Harlem credit. He has taken a lot of punishment, and he's still fighting back.
Harlem Bravado looked like he had this thing won with that big frog splash. And now Lancelot back in the ring. Look out! Oh, drives him down. And look out here. Oh, presses him up into a power slam. Cover here, two, and Ethan Case with a save.
And barely a save. We were, what, half a second away from new tag team champions. But Case firing back, and Lancelot with one in kind. Case again. Lancelot. They're standing toe-to-toe, wailing on each other, and an eye gouge and a nose smear.
Oh,
and it looked like Lancelot was playing possum. Not that time.
Well, both of these guys are just beating the crap out of each other. Ethan Case stops, hits a kick, and now another. And now,
Lancelot saying, come on,
one.
Keep
Lancelot,
doing it.
Yeah, that was finally enough.
And Lancelot says, you want to play games? We can play games. With a vicious forearm.
There are bodies all over the place. It looks like Jonestown the morning after out here.
It looks
here.
Like a car wreck is what it looks like. And now Harlem back in. Harlem, Evans.
Wow, spinning sit-out powerbomb. Is that going to be enough to retain? No!
And look at the Tommy Thomas. Notice how the jacket has come off. He's not quite so confident now, is he?
It could be because he's fat, but no, it's probably because he's not confident.
You keep talking like that, he's going to come over and we'll be stuck with him.
Oh, he'll stay over there. He's got to stay over there. Oh, look out here now. All four guys in the ring. This is bad waiting to happen. Train wreck on the outside. Quick cover here, but oh! Pulls the tights, and now look at Tommy Thomas helping out! Once again, Tommy Thomas interjects himself.
Tommy Thomas.
Tag team champions, the worst case scenario.
Tommy Thomas directly responsible for his team winning by hook or crook. It's ridiculous. But the worst case scenario, unfortunately, makes their first title defense a successful one.
This is preposterous. Something's got to be done about the Tommy Thomas. Worst case scenario, gets another win and another great match. But, God, I'm so sick of the Tommy Thomas.
Once again, the worst case scenario, your PWX Tag Team Champions beating the Bravado Brothers. Well, that'll do it for another episode of PWX Wrestling. For Chris Shore, I'm Bruce Snyder. Thank you so much for joining us.